So, good afternoon, all the jury members. So, basically, my today's research paper topic is about ransomware. Ransomware is a sort of an attack or malicious software that can encrypt all your system files. And basically, it just encrypts and gives you a code or a something, a text file, which and then asks for a ransom for your data. Without that, paying your data to filter out your ransom is extremely tough for me. It's basically just stops you from using your PC, and it holds your PC files for a ransom. And they can target any type of PC user, whether it's a home computer or an endpoint in an enterprise or any government agencies. Some recent attacks in ransomware, as far as I remember, is the Colonial Pipeline, which Colonial Pipeline attack in the
Sorry
U.S.
to interrupt you, Manubhav. Actually, your presentation, we are not able to see your presentation.
Oh, sorry, sir. Sorry, sir. Just a second.
Let me share the presentation.
Is it visible now?
Yes, it is visible. You can make this as a full board.
Sorry, sir.
A full board.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, fine now.
Yeah, so I was saying that they can target any PC user, whether it's home user, endpoint, or any other government agency or a company. So as far as I remember, the most famous ransomware attack that happened recently was a Colonial Pipeline attack in the US, which basically shook the whole US government, where the attackers encrypted their file system, and they asked for a particular ransom, and the government had to pay the ransom for their files. Ransomware can basically encrypt your files and stop running some certain apps in your computer. It can be even applied on lock screen, or when you open a lock screen, it can be applied on a desktop. The whole scenario of the desktop changes, and everything decrypts to a dot RKA or something like that file extension. And there is no guarantee that after you pay your fine, the hackers will give your files back. They can even delete that, or whatever they want, they can do with that. So basically, there are two types of ransomware, like I told: lock screen ransomware and encryption ransomware. Lock screen ransomware shows a full screen message that prevents you from accessing any type of files. And in encryption ransomware, the file extension gets changes, and you cannot open your files without paying the Bitcoin locker, Bitcoin in their Bitcoin trip or any certificate they are asking for. And so how ransomware get access to our PC? So basically, it all depends on the mind of a human nature. They can click on any sort of bad or phishing links, and they can open email attachment which can have some backside trojans or all, which can give a back a reverse shell, TCP reverse shell, so that they can give a access control to the attacker. They can open a like a, for example, they can create notification from Flipkart or Amazon that you have won a voucher, and they can click on that, and your PC can get attacked after that. And they can basically use some beef or XSS trojans or beef framework to hook up their browser and then redirect them to their website for downloading something else like a trojan. And if like I researched, I heard somewhere that if your PC gets attacked by the ransomware, the most safest of go to nomoransom.org to check the decryptor of your ransomware, whether it's present in the database or not. And it's an initiative between law enforcement and IT security companies that aims to help ransomware victims to recover their files. And most important tip regarding this is to always keep a hard copy of your important files rather than depending on soft copy, rather than depending on the copies inside your computer. And so globally, ransomware continues to be a problem. In India also, last year or in the early stages of 2021, the Telangana and Andhra Pradesh had some ransomware attacks. And like Amritsar said in his session, that the ransomware is not going to decrease, it's only going to increase day by day. And so these are some charts regarding that ransomware, how it's increasing and it's affecting day-to-day users and life. So according to me, what experts are doing wrong, experts after facing a ransomware don't perform analysis and learn from the attack. They just keep on doing the same progress again and again without getting themselves updated. Like we can use some IDS or IPS to prevent some firewalls. I'm talking about, you know, IT companies only. A day-to-day normal user should be critical of what he's doing on the internet and what he's clicking on the internet. And big organization should always revise the security policies and should always take care of the security teams of what plans they are performing and what steps to be done, taken care of when anything like this happens. So from here, I conclude my topic.